Hello. This is a 6-year-old girl having the previous episodes of acute appendicitis and multiple gallstone. So we are performing by two port laparoscopic cholecystectomy and appendicectomy. Two Elie's forceps should be applied and the umbilicus has to be everted. And after that, with one 11 number of knife, you can just have a small stab wound over the inferior crease of umbilicus. It is important that various needles should be held in a way that 2 plus thickness of the abdominal wall should be supported. Like you should guard the various needle in a way that more than 4 cm of the various needle should not be exposed. And then you should lift the abdominal wall not near the umbilicus, otherwise it will make a skin fold and various needle will go to the muscles. You should hold it halfway in between the pubic symphysis, press by the left in little finger so that direction should be towards the anus but perpendicular to the abdominal wall. And within 2 click you will be inside. This is irrigation test, this is suction test, and then here it is hanging drop test, and which is sucked in. After that we can attach the insufflation. In the pediatric patient, the preset pressure should be 8 and the flow rate should be 0.1 liter per minute per year of the age. So in this case, just the 800 ml of gas is introduced, and after that this is increased, and you will increase it in a smiling incision, and it is inferior crease of umbilicus like a smiling face, and then you should dilate it caudally to open the obliterated vitreointestinal tract. That is a Scandinavian technique. And then you should hold the trocar in your hand like a pistol, and it should be guarded in a way that only 4 cm should be free, and slowly a screwing movement you will enter inside. And after that telescope will be introduced. In this patient, what we have done, only 2 port we have used. So one port is in the umbilicus and another port is epigastric. That is epigastric. As usual, we put it just left to the falciform ligament. So this is a small 10 millimeter incision in epigastric, just left to the falciform. And then when you put the trocar, initially it should go perpendicular, and after that, as soon as it pierces the, then it should pierce the membranous part of the falciform ligament, and it should go towards the right, so that your elevation, and here just 1 millimeter nick, only 1 millimeter nick, no scar. And this is a striker mini alligator. It goes percutaneously. And by these only, we will perform the cholecystectomy and appendicectomy both. This is a striker mini alligator, which doesn't have any port, and it will not give any scar, any dressing, any cannula is not required. So now this is the gallbladder. And with the striker mini alligator, we will hold it little above the Hartmann pouch, because it has to control the gallbladder as well as liver, and it has to retract it so that it should be not held near the Hartmann, not over the fundus. So striker mini alligator is a 1.8 millimeter instrument, micro instrument, which doesn't leave any scar and doesn't need any trocar. So now little bit adhesion is there and duodenum is pushed down, and little flimsy adhesions are there which is separated. After that you can dissect the posterior peritoneum. Silicon jaw of the harmonic is kept towards the gallbladder so that it should not have any knocking effect, and it cannot transfer the any vibration to the gallbladder. And this is the angle of the cystic pedicle with the body of the gallbladder, that we say the mouth of the elephant, and you can separate the posterior peritoneum, and it has to be very carefully. And now at the same place you will give antro, this is antromedial traction, which will show you posterior peritoneum. And then after opening the posterior peritoneum, you can start giving antrolateral traction, and then you can go and you can just make it. This is Teflon jaw of the harmonic, is keeping the liver lifted up, and just little bit knocking will open the anterior peritoneum. And after that, with the tip of the harmonic, you can do the stripping of the peritoneum here. And this is the cystic pedicle, and skeletonization of the cystic pedicle will be carried out. So this is a stripping of the peritoneum, which carried out. Now to make a anterior and posterior window, the Maryland we prefer because harmonic, the jaw is sharp, so convex edge of the Maryland is towards the liver, and then this is the posterior window. You can open slowly and make it, and then fully the entire jaw of the Maryland is 22 millimeter. So once you will open it, posterior window is created. After that, you can make an anterior window. So this is cystic artery, and below is the cystic duct. So you can make a window in between the artery and duct. And it should be full jaw of the Maryland, that is 22 millimeter. That will help you to allow, although it's a pediatric case, so it is a small thin, but it is dilated. This is cystic duct, which is down there. So this way you can make an anterior and posterior window. In the color triangle, as we know in laparoscopy, inferior surface of the liver is very important to visualize, and both the window is created. So this is the liver, inferior surface of the liver we can see, and it is a window is created. Now in those situations, it is option is up to you. You can use the hemolock, you can use clip, you can use knot. So here the cystic artery, for cystic artery we are using the titanium clip, and you can apply three clip, one clip towards the right hepatic artery. After that you can apply and keep it pressed for 3 seconds to have the plastic deformation. Now another clip just 3 millimeter above that, you can apply another one. Then third clip you can apply 6 millimeter above it. Although in the harmonic sometime we don't apply the third one, we just secure it by the harmonic. But it is optional, it is up to you, you can apply it. So now with the harmonic we are cutting and separating the artery, and it is nicely separated. So this is over, and after that for the duct it is your choice, but here we have used extracorporeal knot. This is extracorporeal knot which you can go from behind, and then you can tie it. So here we will use Mishra's knot. An extracorporeal knot has an advantage that there will be no any cat eye stone, or one of the delayed complications, that is cystic duct clip stone, can be avoided, especially in pediatric cases. And this is a Mishra's knot which you will tie it. Configuration is 1-1-1-1-1. And the cystic duct is nicely ligated, and then you can cut it with the scissors. You can apply one clip also above to prevent any spillage, but in this case we have not applied a clip. With the harmonic itself, it is sealed and it is separated. So now it is separated, and then you can separate the gallbladder. To separate the gallbladder, with the left hand we have to do anteromedial anterolateral traction. Here, because we don't have any third or fourth instrument, and as we know, Stryker mini alligator cannot be repeatedly opened and again rearranged, so you have to be a little compromised, and anteromedial antrotraction has to be given carefully. The another problem that if you are using micro instrument, then in those situations you have to be a little gentle because it can puncture it also. So here we are using the micro instrument, and that is percutaneous instrument, so you have to hold it in a way that you can manage it. Here light cable is kept at 6 o'clock position, and slowly a good areolar plane has to be achieved, and gallbladder can be separated from the liver. During that separation, you should keep the Teflon or silicon jaw of the harmonic towards the liver, so that it will not puncture, because vibration will not be transferred towards the liver. Little blunt dissection time to time is useful, which will make you a plane of dissection to separate. Now it is rearranged, Stryker mini alligator is rearranged so that the traction can be minimized, and then the final part of the fundus of the gallbladder has to be separated. So ergonomically, if you will reduce the number of the ports, little bit difficulty will be there, but it can be managed easily, and the patient has less pain, early recovery, no scar also is observed. In my opinion, two-port cholecystectomy is better than single incision. Now this is final part, but before taking the final part of the fundus of the gallbladder out, one exposure below is good to have, so that you can see that if it is everything is fine. And we are just inspecting below now. So it is right now, the light cable was down, now it is up, and if no blood, everything is clear, dry, and then you can separate the final part of the gallbladder. So this is the way how the cholecystectomy can be done, only by two ports and one percutaneously needle instrument, that is a Stryker mini alligator. Now you can hold it by claw forceps and put the neck of the gallbladder into the cannula, and slowly the entire gallbladder will be taken out. During taking this out, you have to be careful that if there is a packed stone, there are multiple stone in this small child, and there is ovum forceps, with the ovum forceps multiple time you can crush and take all the stone out, and then gallbladder can be taken out. So she was having previous episodes of cholecystitis, and multiple stone, packed gallstones, multiple stone, as you can see, large stones were there, which is crushed by ovum forceps and taken out. Now, after removal of the gallbladder, we will switch the 10 mm cannula in the epigastric, and same Stryker mini alligator is holding, and here the harmonic is in the umbilicus. So with the same ports, you can receive harmonic is in the umbilicus, same port you can do appendicectomy also. Here silicone jaw of the harmonic is kept towards the appendix, so that vibration should not transfer. Actually it is we say it's silicone jaw, but actually it is made up of Teflon and silicone mixed. So now this is again separating, and now slowly you can go up to the base of the appendix, and this Teflon or silicone jaw is towards the cecum, so that any vibration should not pass it over. Incomplete appendicectomy should be avoided, so you should go as near as possible to the base. And now it is separated. So appendicectomy in pediatric cases is a very easy procedure. Now this is a pre-tied Mistral's knot, that is endoloop knot, and then you can put it, and then you can catch the appendix and put the this loop by the knot pusher behind the structure, then bring the tip of the knot pusher over the tinea coli, so that automatically it will come there. So if you want to prevent any incomplete appendicectomy, tip of the knot pusher should be kept over tinea coli, and then as soon as you tight it, it will automatically go to the junction. Only one knot is more than sufficient, and then you can bring the scissors and you can cut it. And after that, with the harmonic itself, you can cut it partially, at one time you should not hold it, so that mucosa also will burn and it will keep on sealing it. And then you can rotate it, and you can catch after partial, then you can catch the full appendix and you can transject it, so that it will burn the mucosa as well and it will seal it also. And then you can hold it longitudinally. So first you hold it very gently and then drop the tip, then automatically it will become longitudinal. And then hold it tightly and put the entire appendix, you have to pull it into the cannula first. This Stryker mini alligator is now dropping the appendix, and the appendix is pulled into the cannula, and then it is taken out. Now here, just this is diagnostic laparoscopy. This is ureter, we can see. There is a common iliac vessel, and this is ureter is crossing the common iliac vessel. This is ureter. There is a sacral perimetry in the middle. Here is the fimbria, and this is the fimbrial end of the tube. And this is a very small, this is the iliac vessel, external iliac artery, external iliac vein, and below is the ovary. This is uterus, very small, because it is only a 6-year-old child, so very small uterus, as you can see, it is visible, and it is not well formed yet. And this is the tube of other side, this is ovary, below is the uterocycle ligament, as you can see, this is sigmoid colon, above is the bladder, and this is uterus, and this is the ovary of this side, still it is developing, and this is the cul-de-sac here. So everything is fine. The bladder is above. This is bladder, little bit getting full. We have not used the any Foley's catheter and all. This is medial umbilical ligament. Here is the deep ring. This is the common iliac vessel of the left side, and this is external iliac vessel. Now if you will just push the telescope inside, here is the ureter. This is the left ureter, which you can see the peristalsis of. This is peristalsis of the left ureter. So everything is fine. This is the uterus, which is very small. And this is the triangle of tomb. So thank you very much for watching this video. Have a nice day. This is just after a few hours of the surgery. We have not put any dressing. Just there was some Neosporin powder. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.